Now, Martin McGuinness, the Deputy First Minister, has called on the government to stop dithering over the devolution of policing and justice. He and the First Minister, Peter Robinson, are due to meet the Prime Minister in London tomorrow. A short time ago, Martin McGuinness told our political reporter, Stephen Walker, that things needed to happen quickly.
But we need to move forward decisively. We need to end any dithering on the issue, and we need to see the issue completed in the interest of all of our people, because I do believe that it wasn't a contentious issue during the course of the election campaign, and that there are huge benefits for our entire community. And we are consistently getting complaints from within the unionist, loyalist, Republican and nationalist community about antisocial behaviour and about attacks on older people, about rapes and about criminal activity and violence being used against citizens. So it's in the interest of everybody that this is expedited as quickly as possible. And the British government have a role to play in that too. Gordon Brown, I think, knows that, because we have majored on the need to ensure that they make their own particular financial contribution to address the legacy issues that have been at the heart of this difficulty for some time.
Is it money that's holding up the devolution of policing and justice?
Well, I think that quite clearly there have been all sorts of discussions with the British government and with the Treasury in the course of recent times. And there is a very strong view here at the Assembly and within the Executive that the British government do need to address the very serious issues that are clearly there in financial terms in relation to the transfer of power. So I think that what we need to do is focus the British government on the need for them to make their particular contribution, and I think we have been focusing them over the course of our discussions in recent times. But it is now time to move forward decisively to make this happen, because it is clearly in the interest of better policing, clearly in the interest of our entire community, that we get this done.
Is it likely that we would see this devolution of power before the end of the year?
Well, you know, I certainly believe that there can be no obstacles put in the way of this. And the arguments that have been raised by the unionist side, for example, in terms of where the DUP were coming from, around the issue of the need for confidence within the community, I think that has been answered quite clearly. Overwhelmingly, people do want to see ministers here taking these decisions in their interests. And the issue of transfer of powers on policing and justice didn't throw itself up as a contentious issue in the course of the campaign or even since.
Would it not make sense to have a target date for the devolution of policing and justice?
Peter Robinson and I have agreed a process, and we have been working our way through that process through the ERC committee here at the Assembly. And we have agreed that there will come a time when he and I will have to decide on a date when this will happen. Now, in the course of the work of the process that we're presently engaged in, there is the issue of the legislation that would be required to be passed here at the Assembly, which I have to say I think is fairly straightforward, and hope to see that happen sooner rather than later. And that will be a further clear indicator that we're moving forward. But I think that, you know, the best message to the rejectionist forces that are out there, whether they're in political parties or within micro-armed groups who think that violence is the way forward, is to get this done, and to get it done quickly, to move decisively, end the dithering, and produce a result for people which clearly shows, and in many ways will symbolise, a new situation in the aftermath of the election, where the DUP and Sinn Féin are seen to be dealing with the difficult issues, taking decisions and moving forward decisively. And policing and justice is but one of a number of issues that we clearly need to deal with.
Martin McGuinness speaking to Stephen Walker there.